Perhaps the most amazing aspect of this particular event in geological history is that it was observed. That is to say, there were humans around. Specifically, the Makalak Indians. Their take on this topographical twitch was that there was a great battle between Lao, chief of the underworld, and Skell, chief of the world above. Skell ultimately drove Lao back underground, collapsing the mountain upon him, and the heavens were victorious. Now, understand, this was no tree falling noiselessly in the woods. It made a sound impossible to ignore, a thunderous and resounding boom. If you've ever stood under a railroad bridge while a freight train passes at full speed 15 feet over your head, you still have no conception of how it sounds when the earth quivers. Nor do I, of course. I'm only pointing it out. I do, however, have an idea of what it sounds like when humanity kicks in its sleep, when history sneezes. I dare not suggest an exaggerated comparison between the two, but I do go so far as to suggest that the murmur of 100,000 people being tickled well past the point of abuse certainly lies far beyond that of the freight train. And in any case, I reckon it's considerably more hair-raising than either the mountain or the train, seeing as how it's emanating from your brothers and sisters. To put it simply and understatedly, it was as unnerving as hearing a thief in the night. Mountains collapsing, trees falling, books toppling over, these are all examples of a phenomenon called punctuated equilibrium. When I first learned about this in graduate school, the professor likened it to a kaleidoscope. When you look through a kaleidoscope and turn it, the pattern very slowly unfolds and changes. This is continuous change. But every so often, the beads tumble over and the pattern collapses into an entirely new one. When this happens, discontinuous change has occurred.